Hello friends, we are into experiment number 7 and the title of this experiment is LC filter or L section filter. Now, so far we have discussed about the series inductor filter and shunt capacitor filter, that is experiment number 5 and experiment number 6. Fine. Now, a simple series inductor filter, it reduces both the peak and effective values of the output current and the output voltage. And on the other hand, the simple shunt capacitor filter, it reduces the ripple voltage, but it increases the diode current, and the diode may get damaged due to a large current, and at the same time it causes greater heating of supply transformer, resulting in reduced efficiency. Fine. So that what we have discussed so far is that in case of an inductor filter, the ripple factor increases with the increase in the load resistance RL, while in a capacitor filter, it varies inversely with the load resistance RL. So this is the outline that we're going to follow for this presentation. Now, the point that we were discussing was, in case of inductor filter, the value of ripple voltage is given as, this is purely for a inductor filter. Okay, the value of ripple factor is RL upon 3 root 2 omega L. Fine, this is for the first case. Second case, for capacitor, the ripple factor R for a full wave rectifier, the ripple factor R with capacitor filter is given as 1 upon 4 root 3 FC RL. RL is the load resistance. Fine. Now, if I look at these two equations, in an inductor filter, the ripple factor increases with the increase in the load resistance. So if I increase the value of load resistance, that is the value of this resistor which is connected across the load, so it increases the value of R. Okay, while in capacitor filter, it varies inversely with the load resistance. Fine. Because RL is inversely proportional to the ripple factor. From economical point of view, neither series inductor nor shunt capacitor filter are suitable. So practical filter circuits are derived by combining the voltage stabilizing action of both capacitor, which is used for current smoothing action of the series choke coil. So by using a combination of inductor and capacitor, the ripple factor can be very much lowered and diode currents can be restricted, and simultaneously the ripple factor can be made almost independent of your load resistance. We will look at the equation later on. Now, the two types of most commonly used combinations are choke input or L section filter and capacitor input or pi filter. So in this experiment, it's all about LC or L section filter. So here is the circuit diagram. So you can see here, in case of choke input filter, it consists of choke L, which is connected in series with the rectifier. So this part is the rectifier part, D1 and D2. So output of which is connected, or which is fed to the choke. And we have a capacitor C, which is connected across the load resistance, R load. Fine. Now, this is also sometimes referred to as L section filter, because in this arrangement, the inductor and capacitor are connected as an inverted L. So it is referred to as L section filter. Now, only in this case, we have shown only one LC section. Okay, only one filter section is shown, but several identical sections are often employed to improve the smoothing action. Okay, so then it is referred to as multiple LC filter. Now, the choke L on the input side of the filter, this filter is readily allowing DC to pass, but it opposes the flow of AC component because its DC resistance is negligibly small, but its AC impedance is large. Any fluctuation that remains in the current even after passing through the choke are largely bypassed around the load by the shunt capacitor, because the reactance XC is very much smaller as compared to RL. Okay, and that too at the ripple frequency. However, a small ripple still remains in the filtered output, and this is considered negligible if it is less than 1%. So theoretically, the value of ripple, which is expressed in percentage, should be less than 1%, is 1.194 divided by LC. How we arrived at this equation has been explained to you all in the online class session. Also, this has been included in this presentation as an analysis, so you can go through it. Now, if you look at this expression, this is for LC filter. Let me mark this as third case, LC filter. This circuit, you don't have this term RL appearing. So inductor filter, okay, RL term is appearing. Here also we are having RL. That means the performance or the value of this ripple depends upon the value of RL, that is the load resistance. And what is load is our application. Now, in case of LC filter, look at this expression. We don't have any RL component. That means what? In case of LC filter, your output voltage is independent of your R load. Okay, meaning the ripples are independent of your R load, load resistance. So the aim is to study the operation of full wave rectifier with and without LC or L section filter. So there are two sets of observation. One will be purely a output of rectifier without connecting inductor and capacitor. And for second case, we are going to connect inductor and capacitor as shown in the circuit diagram. Fine. These are the components required. And again, these values are as per design. So we have taken 22 microfarad so that we can get fairly a ripple voltage, so that we can, you know, make out how much is the ripple value. For that reason, we have taken less value of capacitance. And we have also varied the value of inductance from 2-3 values, so you can make out the difference, okay, in the ripple voltage. So here is the circuit diagram. So we are not going to details of the derivation of this LC filter because this has been covered in the class. So you can, again, the video has been uploaded, you can refer to that online lecture. This is the theory. You can pause the slide, you can go through it. Now here is the derivation for ripple factor of LC filter. So R equals to 1.194 divided by LC. So here is the procedure. Missed out the formula here. The formula is R equals to 1.194 divided by LC. These are the model waveforms. So this is the without filter. So without connecting the inductor and capacitor, we are expected to get this kind of a waveform, and this is referred to as what? Pulsating DC. And when we mount the inductor and capacitor as shown in the circuit diagram, this is what we are going to get, the output voltage. Okay, this is the one. So this is nothing but a ripple voltage. Now there are two parts to this experiment. You have to calculate the ripple voltage theoretically and graphically, that is practically. Theoretically, the value of R is 1.194 divided by LC. And to find the practical value of ripple, we need to know what is the value of Vm, that is this value, VL max, okay? And we can also write this as Vm. And we should know what is the value of Vr peak to peak. What is Vr peak to peak? Vr is the ripple voltage. This small signal what you see here is the ripple voltage. And if we are interested in finding the peak to peak value of it, so this value is Vr peak to peak. So from the demonstration video, you have to pause during the output when it is observed on the CRO. Okay, take the screenshot and check out the value of Vm and Vr peak to peak. And how do I use these values in the graphical analysis is shown in the demonstration video, so I'm not repeating it again here. Observations, you have to note down the theoretical value of ripple factor. Theoretical meaning using the component values, that is L and C, and practical using the value of Vm and Vr peak to peak. So without filter and with filter. And then you have to note down the results. So there will be definitely some mismatch in the ripple factor obtained from a practical setup to that which we can obtain from the formulae, that is theoretical ripple factor. Then again, after watching the demonstration video, you need to write the conclusion, what you have understood from that experiment in your own words. Don't copy from the others because it carries marks. So here are the precautions. The all the connections should be correct and verify the output of center tap transformer. Or the outcomes of this session, and you can download the write-up from this link provided, and I'll also upload this write-up in our online classroom, so you can refer to it. So now let us start with the demonstration video.
Hi friends, in this particular video we'll be learning, we'll be conducting practicals of LC filter, that is inductor capacitor filter. We have already done practicals for capacitor filter separately and inductor filter separately. Now for this particular we'll be doing combination of L and C, and that filter is called as LC filter. Okay, now if you have seen our previous video, if I remove this C, it is the same LC filter. Okay, if I remove this C, it is the same LC filter. Okay, and then we saw across this load, when this inductor was there, we were getting output like this. Okay, so we had Vm something like this, and then this was the output of the inductor filter. Now what is happening is that we are connecting extra capacitor across the load resistor. So what will be the good thing about this capacitor will be, it will again reduce the ripple to a lower value, and hence your output will have less ripple. So this is the advantage of having capacitor filter also with L filter. So L anyways, inductor filter is reducing the ripple, and then again this capacitor filter will reduce it more. So we'll see this practically. Okay, so this is what it is. The formulas and everything remain the same. Okay, now what we'll do is that we'll connect the circuit. So what we need, we need a diode, we need two diodes, we need a inductor box, we need a capacitor, okay, and then we need a resistor. Okay, so coming to here, so we have our center tap transformer. Okay, so these are the two windings and this is the center tap winding. So we connect a diode first. Okay, so diode is connected. Okay, then we will be connecting a inductor in series. Okay. Okay. Next we'll be connecting a resistor. Okay. And then finally, output of this resistor is again connected to the center tap winding. Okay, the only thing what is remaining is the capacitor that you have to connect. It has to be connected across the resistor. So this is positive, this is lead is positive. See, in this capacitor no negative is mentioned, always the negative lead is mentioned. So the other lead automatically becomes the positive lead. Okay, you will not get any positive sign here, always you will get negative sign here. So across the capacitor, across the resistor, you have to connect a capacitor like this. Okay, so these are the basic circuit connections, okay, that you need to know. Okay, now so if you see this is the reading when only inductor is there. Okay, we have done this last time, and then it is at the inductor is set to 7 Henry, and we had found out that the value of this VR peak to peak is 0.5 into 5. Okay, so this is the output of a simple inductor filter. Now here, now what we are doing in, now you see the circuit diagram. Now what we will be doing is that we will be connecting an extra capacitor. Just see how the waveform changes. Okay, so I have taken a 22 microfarad capacitor here. You can see here 22 microfarad capacitor. Okay, and then this is negative, and then so the other will be positive. Okay, other side. So what I am doing, trying to do is I will just connect it across the resistor. So I am connected across the resistor. just see what happened to the ripple. See how much it decreased. Okay, see, it is almost like a flat line, or it has reduced to a very considerable extent. Okay, so now what if we want to measure VR peak to peak, what we need to do is that now it is at 5 volts, no, channel 1. Okay, so we need to reduce this. Okay, so I am reducing this so that we can at least measure. So I guess this is good. Okay, so how much is the ripple? You can measure from here. How much is VR peak to peak? Sorry. Okay, so VR peak to peak is around 0.4. Okay, it is around 0.4. I guess it is 0.4. Yes, it is around 0.4. 0.4 into 0.5. Okay, now just make a note of this. Okay, so VR peak to peak with capacitor or 22 microfarad, right? Okay, is around 0.4 into 0.5 volts. So this is, you have to get an answer for this. Okay, and VM, we had already calculated it for our last experiment. If you see the last experiment, VM we had already calculated, it was around, okay, what we'll do, we'll calculate it now also. So no tension for that. Okay, so if you can see here, it is 2.8. Okay, this is VM, no, VM. Okay, so 2.8 into 5 volts. Okay, so VM is 2.8 divisions into 5 volts. So this volts you have got. Okay, so what you need to do is that only you have to substitute it again to the formulas here, VDC. Okay, and finally you will get the output. Okay, it is very simple. Okay, what you have to learn in this particular experiment is after you have connected the capacitor to a inductor filter, it has reduced the ripple. Okay, so thank you.